A lot of the aluminum Intel iMacs are reaching the age where they're no longer covered under Apple's warranty, so a problem like a failing power supply might make you think that you're in the market for a new computer. But before you go reaching for that credit card, keep in mind that repairing these machines is quick and cheaper than buying a whole new computer. And although the lack of obvious screws might make you think this is an impossible repair, it's actually pretty easy. Hi, I'm MJ with iFixit, and today I'm going to show you how to replace the power supply on an aluminum Intel iMac. I'm just going to give you an overview of the process, so while you're doing your repair, as always, you'll want to follow the step-by-step instructions in the repair guide on our site. Different versions of iMac will use different power supplies, so make sure you order the right replacement by verifying your machine's EMC number, which can be found on the underside of the base of the iMac. If you don't see it there, head to the ID Your Mac page on our site and look it up that way. Today I'm working on a 20-inch iMac EMC number 2210. For this repair, you're going to need a set of heavy-duty suction cups, a plastic spudger, a Phillips number 1 screwdriver, and 3 Torx screwdrivers, T6, T8, and T10. All of those can be found in our 54-piece bit driver kit. Of course, you'll need a replacement power supply and also some cleaning solution and a soft cloth. All of these things can be found at iFixit.com. Removing the glass is my favorite part, but before I do that, I'm going to remove the RAM access door. The screw isn't going to come out entirely, so once it's loosened, you can just lift the whole thing right off. Now that the door is off, we're going to use the heavy-duty suction cups to remove the glass. All you've got to do is just push it on there and then flip the little handle up and do the same thing for the other one. And once these are both on here, just lift straight up and it should come off fairly easily. It's held on by magnets, so it shouldn't be too much of a struggle. Now that the glass is off, I can see all the screws that are holding the bezel in place, so I'm going to switch to my T8 bit and remove all of those. Now that all those screws are removed, I can remove the bezel, and I'm going to start near the top of the computer and work my way down. Once it's loose, you'll notice that it's still connected to the computer by the microphone cable, so we're going to want to disconnect that before we lift the whole bezel off. The next big step is to remove the LCD, but before I can do that, I'm going to need to disconnect a couple of cables and remove a couple more screws. Once everything is disconnected and all those screws are removed, I'm going to lift the LCD off, starting on the left side and rotating it towards the right side. And what you'll see is that it is still connected to the logic board via these inverter cables down here. And this is kind of the tricky part. You can either prop this up on something and then disconnect them, or maybe ask a friend for help to hold this up for you while you disconnect the cables. With the LCD removed, we can see the power supply, but before we remove it, a word of caution. Even though the computer is not connected to power, the capacitors in the power supply can still hold voltage, so try not to touch the face of the power supply. With that in mind, I'm going to remove the 4 screws that are holding it in place. With those screws out, there are just a couple of cables to disconnect on the underside of the power supply. The first one is kind of small and delicate, and you don't want to pull it out by the wire. You actually want to use your fingernails to grab onto the connector and remove it that way. The big one next to it has a latch on the underside of it, so you want to lift the latch up and then disconnect it. And this very last cable has a latch also, so you're going to lift that up and then disconnect it. And that's it. It's out. All I have to do is reconnect my new power supply and put my iMac back together. I have a couple of notes on reassembly. Don't forget to thoroughly clean both the LCD and the glass panel before you reinstall them. There's nothing worse than putting all those screws back in only to realize that you've trapped a bunch of fingerprints and dust on the inside. Also, before you put the bezel back on, don't forget to reconnect the microphone cable. It's really easy to rush through reassembly and totally skip that part. Of course, you can find all of the parts and tools for this and many other repairs at iFixit.com. And if you run into any problems during your repairs, there are lots of solutions in the iMac repair guide on our site. Thanks for watching and happy repairing!